Good morning, my friends. My name is Lama Jigme, and this is Enlightened Fitness. First, we're going to use high-intensity bodyweight interval training to cultivate the body of a tantric sex god. And then we'll use guided meditation to cultivate both the heart and the mind of a Buddha. Sounds like fun, doesn't it? Now, if this is your first time tuning in, let's let you know that about 3 inches below the video, there's a button that reads Show More. And you click that with your mouse, it'll reveal a list of links as long as my arm. Those links are crucial. They'll tell you how to do the exercises exactly as I do them, easier than I do them, and more challenging than I do them. It'll tell you how to do a warm-up. It'll tell you how to meditate. It's wonderful. And those links will also tell you about diet. The second link will tell you about diet. It'll give you some resources that are nominal at Amazon.com and some resources that are absolutely free over the internet, which is great. So here's the deal. It's been said by experts that at least 70% of fat loss and fitness is all about what you do with your mouth, what you cook in the kitchen. That's why I recommend the low-fat, whole-food, plant-based diet espoused by many physicians, including Dr. Graham, Dr. McDougall, and Dr. Barnard. I'm going to read you a portion from one of Dr. McDougall's books, his program for maximum weight loss. It'd probably be easier if I put my glasses on first. Here we go. It isn't just fat you're losing either. Repeated dieting and weight gain, or the yo-yo syndrome, is not only ineffective, but actually deleterious to health because of the kinds of changes produced in body composition. With weight loss during periods of semi-starvation, otherwise known as dieting, you lose considerable muscle mass along with fat, especially if you don't exercise while you diet. But after you give up the diet, the weight you regain is primarily fat. The net effect of dieting is that your body consists of more fat and less muscle at the same weight. Muscle, which is very active tissue, consumes many more calories than fat tissue. Even while you are resting, healthy muscle burns calories. Fat, on the other hand, is mostly stored calories. Consequently, when you replace muscle with fat, you're actually taking away the very tissues that would help you lose weight in the future. This makes it more likely that you will stay fatter as you convert muscle into fat. Meanwhile, you blame your appetite for the excessive desire to eat, and you blame yourself for your pitiful lack of willpower. These feelings were reinforced by a chorus of expert voices saying, to lose weight, you must cut down, and calories are the only thing that count. Overweight people declare, the reason I'm fat is I overeat. I can't control my appetite. Now remember, if this is your first time tuning in, that's a myth. We are designed to eat a certain number of calories a day. If we don't, we're going to lose our mind. Our body is determined not to let us starve, where foodstuffs are available. So it's not a question of starving yourself, but of giving yourself the healthiest foods possible. That's why we recommend a low-fat, whole-food, plant-based diet. So for instance, instead of grape soda, have some grapes right off the vine. Instead of salty corn chips, have some celery. It's delicious. Instead of savory beef stew, have some savory lentil soup. It's delicious. You'll be glad you did. So here you go. So tomorrow we will cover trying to fool Mother Nature. Now it's time for our workout. Okay, my friends, let's begin by warming up with two repetitions of Indian-inspired 12-phase sun salutation. Okay, we're a little warmed up now, a little warmer. Perhaps we've broken a sweat. Perhaps we're breathing deeper. Welcome to 5 circuits, 4 exercises each. For sure, any fool, and I'm going to quote Albert Einstein for a moment. Any intelligent fool can make things bigger, more complex, and more violent. It takes a touch of genius and a lot of courage to move in the opposite direction. Any fitness instructor with a computer and an internet connection can give you a new exercise every day. But I'm going to give you an economy of exercises. Just 4 exercises per circuit and designed to get you the body you want as easily, as quickly as possible in a sustainable way that you can do every day, comfortably, easily, conveniently. Having said that, we're going to dig in with our first set, first circuit, jumping toe squats. Okay, let's do straight thrusts. Underhanded chin-ups using the door straps. Very cheap solution. Welcome to the second circuit. Let's do some heel squats. Non-jumping. Also known as crawling presses. Okay. twisting thrusters. Let's do pull-ups. Welcome to the third circuit. Again with the legs, again with jumping toe squats. Wow. Pressing. Third set of pressing, tent press or piking press. Okay, let's do thrusts. Third circuit of thrusts. These are going to be straight. Third set of pulls, these will be chins. Welcome to the fourth circuit. We return to legs. This time heels. Heel squats. Wow. Okay, fourth press, reptiles. Okay. Fourth thrusts, these will be twisted. Okay, fourth pull. These will be pull-ups. final circuit. Jumping to squats. Wow. Piking press. Okay, twist, straight thrusts. Okay. Final chin-ups. Okay, as promised, right now you should be out of breath and dripping with sweat. Let's continue reading from an English translation of Kardama Chagme's root text entitled The Quintessence of Spiritual Practice, the Direct Instructions from the Great Compassion. It was written in the 1700s, if my memory is correct. By a pioneer in the field of Rime Manipa, a non-sectarian devotion to the Buddha of Compassion. He is pretty much rooted in the fundamentalism. So I'll provide you commentary
from a liberal perspective.
Dedicate all your virtuous deeds to the universal benefit of all beings. To try to benefit others as much as you are able will suffice for keeping the Bodhisattva precepts. So what does that mean?
If this is not your first time tuning in, you'll remember that at the end of every session, after the exercise, after meditation, after the yoga, after the sun salutation, we recite, or actually during the sun salutation, three recitations. And I tell you that those recitations do three things. They protect our good karma, they share our good karma, and they multiply our good karma. And doing so is the essence of all the vows of compassion. Pretty neat, huh? Water, beverage of choice. In the previous guided meditation, it lasted approximately 36 minutes. Today's guided meditation will last approximately 39 minutes. And if you notice that these guided meditations are marked in intervals of three, you may be onto something. Now, I talked about those links under the video. The first link will take you to a page in my website where all the Enlightened Fitness videos have been double organized. First, they're organized by length of workout, and they're put in their own separate boxes. There's a 10-minute box, a 12-minute box, an 8-minute box, a 2-minute box. You get the idea. But within each box, the videos are organized by length of guided meditation. So if this is your first time watching my talking head, turn this video off and go find a video with just a 3-minute guided meditation. Even if you've been meditating for 20 years, you should have no problem exercising humility going back to a 3-minute meditation. If you can't, well, then your meditation must have taken a wrong turn. Let's begin by warming up using a sutric breathing exercise known in Pali as anapanasati, or mindfulness with breathing. Remember, there are links below the video to tell you how to sit comfortably and other links to tell you how to count the creases of your fingers. How long breath? Releasing. Remember to breathe deep. Let's do it for another set of 9 breaths. How long breath? releasing. And remember, these questions are rhetorical. We don't answer them. We just ask the question on the in-breath, relax on the out-breath. How long breath? Releasing. We're going to switch now to the one-syllable paradigm. Breathe free. Okay, that completes our first 3 minutes. Let's move now to Hova's rehearsal of the transference of consciousness at the moment of death. We'll begin with universal compassion. That intends for everyone to take an auspicious rebirth at the very end of their current lives. Give to each great rebirth. Now we turn our attention to ourselves. Great rebirth, out through crown. Wear crown om, releasing. Om free. What seeing, releasing. See free. grin with eyes, releasing. Noticing, relaxing. This ease. Now that we've completed our 6th minute of guided meditation, let's play with a very concise version of Guru Yoga. Thanks for what? Releasing. Thanks, teacher. Releasing. Blend with mind at this heart. Wear heart free, releasing. Free. What feeling, releasing? Feel free. Grin with lips, releasing. Noticing, relaxing. We've just completed the 9th minute of guided meditation. Now we're going to do a set of contemplations that fit under the heading of Lam Rim, which I like to translate as steep path, easy stairs, or gentle steps. We're going to begin with a set of renunciation contemplations. How me not satisfy. Why turn from suffering's cause? How karma be quite just? How this chance be precious. Now let's turn our attention to Tong Lin's union of compassion that takes suffering and the love that gives blessing. How could each be kind of all? Why take fear as black smoke? How are all more than me? Why give peace as white light? In through nose, out through pores. Take fear smoke, give peace light. Fear, peace. Now we switch to the wisdom of letting go. Where feel me releasing. How am I dependent? How could I always change? How could I not be me? How could I not be mine? How could I not be grasped? How sights like Potala. How here like Totala. How sound like the Mani. We have shortened the word body into bod. How bod like chain raising? Chain raising is the Buddha of compassion. We're going to shorten the word sensation down to sen. How sen like chain raising? So let's see, so far we've accomplished 18 minutes of guided meditation. Let's work with the basic metta, loving kindness. Then we're going to give wisdom. How wise good, releasing. How wise feel releasing. Now to me, give wisdom. Now to some, give wisdom. Give to all great wisdom. We're going to basically say, how are feelings like great love? But we're going to reduce the number of syllables. How feelings like great love. Now to each, give wisdom. Each wise. Now we're going to do a very basic vipassana wisdom practice. What hearing releasing? what seeing, releasing, what feeling, releasing. How could this be funny? Grin with lips, releasing. How thoughts like great wisdom. Noticing, relaxing. This ease. Just completed the 24th minute of guided meditation. Now we're going to start with the Chog Chain category of practices. We're going to start with the Tummo, the secret elective Tummo. There's two electives for Tummo, one at navel and one at the secret wheel. The secret wheel is mysterious. It's just four finger widths below the navel wheel. It's called secret because it doesn't have an external mark. That's all. Very simple. Tummo means inner flame. It's either chandili or the Sanskrit word is chandili or something very close to that. I'm not a very good linguist. So today we're going to play with reverse breathing. Not only is it taught in Tantric Buddhism, but also in Tantric Taoism. So what we're going to do is on the in-breath is if you're a woman, you're going to squeeze your anus and your urethra and your vaginal orifice while pulling your lower abdomen in. On the out-breath, you're going to relax. If you're a boy, on the in-breath, you're going to squeeze tight your anus, your urethra, and your to the tissues of your perineum while also pulling your lower abdomen tight, in tight. On the out breath, you're going to relax those four points. So let's begin with we're going to contemplate the location of the secret wheel. Remember, these are rhetorical questions. Our body already knows where it is. So on the in breath, we're going to ask, where seek wheel? On the out breath, we're going to intend releasing. Let's play with that right now. Where seek ha, releasing ha, ha is a little teeny syllable the size of a mustard seed. At the very center or the hub of the horizontal secret wheel, there is a central channel that we imagine that begins 4 finger widths below the navel and is about a thumb's width before the spine, and it ascends up. And when it comes to the crown, it arches forward like a cane and terminates between the eyebrows. Imagine that this, this central channel is the width of a pencil, and it's intersected by a horizontal wheel at the level of 4 finger widths below your navel. That secret wheel is about the size of your thumbnail. In the center, there's a hub. And at the hub, we imagine a little, either a syllable ha or the letter H, whichever we prefer. Once again, our job is not to visualize perfectly. Our job is to ask the question and relax on the out-breath. That's it. While, of course, performing reverse breathing. So it's going to be, where seek ha, releasing. We can imagine there's a little teeny tiny flame inertly burning at the top of the H that doesn't hurt us, that just delights us and gives us bliss. Where ha flame releasing. Ha free. That was a fun, bliss-centered concentration. We call that union of bliss and openness. Now we're going to travel up the central channel with a series of fun, short, transitionary contemplations. How seek flame? Oh, let's try that again. Seek flame stretch out left soul. See flame stretch out right soul. See flame stretch up to nave. See flame stretch up to heart. See flame stretch out left palm. See flame stretch out right palm. See flame stretch up to throat. See flame stretch up to crown. See flame stretch out through brow. And now we say goodbye to our reverse breathing, return to normal, standard, spontaneous breathing. Brow drop, climb up to crown. Crown, where crown wheel, releasing. Where crown ohm, releasing. Ohm free. That was the union of bliss and openness. And now we turn our attention to the union of love and openness. Crowns joy light from white ohm. Crowns joy light, bless body. Crowns joy light, bless bonds being. Joy lights. Now bless here. Crowns joy lights. Bless here's being. Crowns joy lights, now bless earth. crowns joy light, bless earth's beings. Crowns joy light, bless all worlds. Crowns joy light, bless all beings. All beings melt into worlds. All worlds melt into Earth. Earth's beings melt into Earth. Earth now melts into here. Here's beings melt into here. Here now melts into me. I'm sorry, here now melts into Bod. Bod's beings melt into Bod. Body melts into Om. Crown Om melts into space. Vast expanse, empty void. Vast void. now we're going to do, we're going to conclude with a very simple Vipassana practice. It's visually oriented, so it can be categorized as a Togal practice, leap over practice of Dzogchen's great conclusion. With seeing, releasing. See free. How could this be funny? Grin with eyes, releasing. Noticing, relaxing. This ease. We're going to conclude with our final set of 3 minutes. It will be a simple metta practice. How love good? Releasing. How love feel? Releasing. Give to me love for all. Give to some love for all. Give to all, love for each. Give to each, love for all. Each, love. That concludes today's 39-minute guided meditation. Now, if that took longer than 39 minutes, that's probably because of my parenthetical explanations. I'm sure if you jotted down all the contemplative notation and practiced it by yourself, it would take you approximately 39 minutes. In today's practice, we performed sutra and tantra. Form the anapanasati, or mindfulness with breathing, meditation, the renunciation, the compassion, the love meditations, the vipassana, the wisdom meditations, and the analytical letting go meditations of sutra. We practice the tantric meditations of guru yoga, powa, dzogchen, toglen, Togal, Trekcho, as well as Tumo from the Chogchen series. So we practice the Tantra and Sutra. We practice creation stage, completion stage, and great completion stage. We practiced Sutras, renunciation, compassion, wisdom, and love. Practice like this twice a day, every day, you will be transformed. I invite you now to join me for a gentle set of geriatric yoga, which comes to us from the Gelug tradition. So far we've practiced items from the Nyingma tradition, the Kagyu tradition. We're about to practice something from the Gelug tradition, as well as the Kadam tradition of Tibet. And if all goes well, our next class we'll practice things that can be attributed to the Sakya tradition. Please sit erect. Please lace your hands behind your tush. Please open your chest. Twist to the left. Why give wise? Releasing. Please reverse that to each. Give wisdom. Back to center. Please release your hands. Please lace them in your lap, swing them out and overhead. Please bend to the left. Why give peace? Releasing. FREEBIES reverse now to each give great peace. Let's make our way into downward facing fetal position, which is also known as child's pose.
Please lay more. Curl your hands into fists, press your knuckles into your, knee to mat with your elbows in, as if you're going to jab.
So rapidly strain your arms, ride the momentum into the seated samurai position, which is also known as lion's pose. Please place your hands behind your tush, open your chest, drop your head, and roll your gaze up. What feeling? Releasing. What hearing? Releasing. What seeing? Releasing. Please release your hands. Push your palm, cup your palms. Press your hands together so that the center of each palm is hovering just before the upper third of your chest. Please relax your shoulders down and twist to the left. Why give joy? Releasing. Back to center, release your shoulders down, twist to the right. Give to each, now to each, give great joy. Back to center. Let's make our way to the hands and knees position in preparation for cat-cow asana. Open mouth, slack jaw, now to each, give comfort. Please stand up. Please place your weight on the major and minor ball of each foot, right behind the big and little toe. Heels off the ground, knees subtly bent, hands laced behind the tush, chest open, head dropped, eyes, gaze rolled up. How could this be funny? Grin with lips, releasing. Noticing, relaxing. Okay. Please join me for two repetitions of 12 phase sun salutation. Whilst we recite the three final recitations that are found at the end of every lesson, we're referring, of course, to the links below the video. There's a link to take you to the class materials page where you can download the latest free PDF for the first set of lesson texts. Each lesson text concludes with these three recitations. You recite them every morning and you recite them every evening. Within a week or two, you will have accidentally memorized them. Let's take off. By this virtue manual accomplish, the spontaneous, habitual, easy, and effective mastery of Buddha's mental yoga. Of wisdom, peace, love, and joy. And now lead every living being, without exception, to this crown. Everyone be healthy, wealthy, and happy. Everyone practice skillfully and joyfully. Everyone accomplish everything in this life.
And then...
maybe want to accomplish dreams in this life and then help many others do likewise. For truly that is the meaning of life. Om mani padme hum. Okay, to your petitions. The Vietnamese inspired vows. May I always be cared for throughout all my lives by the Buddha of infinite light emanating as my kind teacher. And as such, may I always enthusiastically and joyfully tread this excellent path praised by the conquerors. My friends, I thank you for your time and your kind attention. I thank you for your enthusiasm to be your best, not just physically, but spiritually, and as well as your support. May you and yours be healthy and happy. Om mani padme hum. Before we go, I want to remind you to find the subscribe button up here. Give that a click. Please look for the like button. Give that a click, as well as the share button. At the very end of this video, in the upper left-hand corner, you'll notice a YouTube icon. If you click that, it'll take you to your home page. On the left-hand side, if you scroll down, you'll find a tab that reads Manage Subscriptions. I invite you to look up either Lama, Jigme, or look up Enlightened Fitness, and you'll notice a box to the right. Use your mouse to put a check in that box, and that way, the next time I upload a video, you'll receive a notification email. How cool is that? Now, before I go, I'll refer to those links below the video once again. One of those links you could use to help keep this monk fed, which would be beautiful, but not mandatory. The most important thing is that you simply do your homework. There's also a link that you could use to register for the next series of live weekly webinars. When do those webinars begin? Tuesday, the 2nd of July. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.